Today, I am going to start Unit 5, Microcontroller Programming and Applications. The topics of this unit are Simple Programming Exercises, Keyboard and Display Interface, Control of Servo Motor, Stepper Motor Control, and Application to Automation. Under this, I am considering Washing Machine Control. Let us discuss one by one. As I have already discussed, the instruction set of 8051 microcontroller addressing modes and example programs in Unit 3 in detail. Let us see some more example programs. The first example, largest element in an array, let internal memory location say 40 has the biggest number, that is 0. Now the biggest number in internal memory location is stored in memory as the result. Now compare the first number with internal memory location. If it is greater, move it to internal memory. Here the input, that is 8600, is the data address. Here totally 10 datas we are taken. The datas are 05, 09, 06, 05, 03, 07, 08, 0B, 7F and 04. Let's see the program. The first instruction, move DPTR, hash 8600. So already you know 8600 is the data address. This address is moved to data pointer. Then 00 is nothing but 8-bit data. So in this program, we want to find out largest number. So initially the smallest value is compared with given data. Okay, so first the smallest value, that is 8 bit smallest number, is 00. This data is moved to internal memory location say 40. Okay, then 0A is nothing but total number of datas. This data is moved to register 5, R5 register. Then DPTR is nothing but 8600 content is moved to the accumulator. So 8600 content is nothing but 05. This data is moved to accumulator register. Then CJNE, C means compare, jump not equal. Okay, first compare internal memory location with accumulator content. If not equal means, then jump to the loop 1 location. Okay, here the first data 05. This 05 is compared with internal memory location, that is 00. These two datas are not equal, so it moves to loop 1 location. So loop 1 is nothing but JC loop 3. Okay, JC means jump carry. The accumulator value, that is internal memory location content, is subtracted from the accumulator content. Then check the carry flag. If carry value is equal to 1 means, then jump to the specified loop location, that is loop 3 location. Like here 05 minus 00, there is no carry, so it moves to the next instruction, that is move 40 comma A. Now accumulator value is 05, so this 05 is moved to internal memory location. Okay, then next instruction, SJMP, that is short jump loop 3. So loop 3 means again increment data pointer. Okay, then decrement jump no 0. Okay, that is decrement R5 register content. After decrement operation, then check the R5 register content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means, then the control is transferred to loop 2 location. So loop 2 means, that is data pointer content is moved to accumulator. So now the data pointer is nothing but 09. Okay, this data is moved to accumulator. So this data is compared with internal memory location. Now the internal memory location content is 05. So 09 is compared with 05. It is not equal. So again loop 1. So loop 1 means here jump carry. Okay, that is 09 minus 05. Here there is no carry. No carry means then move to the next instruction. That is accumulator is moved to internal memory location. So here accumulator value is 09. So this value is moved to the internal memory location. Then short jump, that is loop 3. So loop 3 is nothing but increment data pointer. The same operation is repeated till the R5 register reaches 0. Okay, the R5 register reaches 0 means that time check the internal memory location content. Okay, that is the largest value of given data. Okay, so that value is stored in next memory location, that is 860A. Okay, so 860A is nothing but result address. In that address, the final answer, that is largest value, is stored. So this is about largest element in an array. Second example, programs for sorting. So in this program, we are going to learn how to arrange data from smallest to largest number, which is called ascending order. For this, the data is compared with another one. This process repeats until the output is achieved. I will show you how this is carried out. The sorting technique used here is relatively simple. First, consider the first two numbers of the array, that is 05 and 08. Out of these two data, find the lowest number. So here lowest number is 05. So retain the data in the same address. Okay, so that is the first operation. So after comparison, the 05 is maintained in the same address location, because comparing 05 and 08, 05 is the lowest number. Okay, then decrement the R1 register. Okay, already R1 register value is 05. After comparing first two data, the R1 register is decremented by 1, that is R1 value is 04. Okay, in second operation, the 08 is compared with 07. Comparing these two data, 07 is the lowest number. So replace the 7 in the position of 08. See here. So the first data, that is 05. Here I am replacing 07 in 08th position. Okay, then 08, then 06, then 04. Copy the remaining value. Then after execution of this instruction, again the R1 register is decremented by 1. That is R1 value is 3. Then third comparison, 07 is compared with 06. Now the lowest number is 06. So replace 06 in the place of 07. Okay. See here, already the 07 is in second position. Now 06 comes. That time the R1 register value is decremented by 1. So R1 value is 2. Then again comparison operation, that is 06 is compared with 04. Here 04 is the lowest number. So 04 comes to the position of 06. That is 05, 04, then 06, 07, 08. Now the R1 register value is 1. It does not reach a 0. So again the same operation will repeat. In last comparison operation, that is 04 is compared with 05. Now, the 04 is the lowest number. So, replace 04 in position of 05, that is 04, 05, 06, 07 and 08. Now, the register 1 reaches 00. So, the processor stop the program. Okay. See the program. Move R0, hash 05. So, 05 indicates total number of data. This data is moved to R0 register. Then, R0 content is moved to accumulator register. From accumulator, the same value is moved to R1, that is copied into R1. Okay, then 8600 is nothing but data address. This data address is moved to data pointer. Then the same address is loaded into temporary register, that is stack pointer. DPH and DPL value is loaded into stack pointer using push instruction. Then DPTR content is moved to accumulator, that is the first data is moved to accumulator. From accumulator, it is loaded into F0 register. Then increment data pointer, then get the second data, that value is loaded into accumulator. After loading, then compare data 1 with the data 2. Okay, if not equal means, then move to the loop 1. Okay, here loop 1 is nothing but J and C loop. Here check the carry flag value, whether carry present or not. If not means, the control is transferred to loop instruction. Suppose, if carry value present means, then it comes to the next instruction, that is, the memory address is retrieved from the stack pointer using pop instruction. Okay, in that address, the accumulator value will be stored, then increment data pointer, then F0 content is moved to accumulator, that content is stored in data pointer. Okay, then decrement R1 register value. Then check the R1 register value whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means the same operation will continue. Otherwise, it moves to the next instruction, that is decrement R0 register. Check the R0 content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means again same operation. Repeat the same operation till R0 register reaches 0. If it reaches 0 means, then move to the next instruction, that is short jump. So, short jump is nothing but, instead of halt instruction, short jump instruction is used. So, using this instruction, the program can stop the process. So, this is the program for sorting an array. The next slide shows square root of a given number. A square root of a number, A is a number Y such that y square is equal to a, or in other words, a number y whose square, that is the result of multiplying the number by itself, or y into y is a. For example, 3 is a square root of 9 because 3 square is nothing but 9. So here data is nothing but 8 bit number. Here I am considering data, that is a 09. The data is stored at 8600. So, 8600 is nothing but data address. See the program. 8600 data address is moved to data pointer. Then the data pointer content is moved to the accumulator register. Then accumulator content is moved to R1. Then 01 is moved to R2. So, what is R1? R1 is nothing but 09. R2 is nothing but 01. Okay. Then R1 value is moved to accumulator register. Then R2 is moved to F0. Okay. Then divide A by B register. So, A is nothing but accumulator register, that is 09. B is nothing but 01. So, 9 divide by 1, that is quotient value 9, remainder value 0. So, accumulator value is moved to R3. So, accumulator stores the quotient value. So, here first time in division operation, the quotient value was 9. That value is moved to R3. So, R3 is nothing but 09. Then F0 value is moved to R4. F0 is nothing but 01. So 01 is moved to R4. So R4 content is 01. Okay, then subtract B accumulator with R2 register. So that is accumulator value is nothing but 09. R2 is 01. So 9 minus 1, the answer is 8. Check the 0 flag, whether the 0 flag is 0 or not. If the 0 flag is a set, then the control is a transfer to result location. But here the 0 flag is not 0, so it moves to the next instruction, that is increment R2. So R2 is incremented by 1, that is already R2 value is 1. After execution of INC R2 value is 02. Okay, then next instruction, short jump loop, that is the control is transferred to loop label. So loop label is nothing but move A, R1. So R1 value is moved to accumulator register. Then R2 value is moved to F0. So R2 is nothing but 02. So again division operation, that is A divide by B. A register value, that is 09. Then B register value 02. Now the quotient value is 04. Remainder value 1. So quotient value is available in accumulator register. Then remainder value is available in B register or F0 register. Then the accumulator value is moved to R3 register. Then F0 content is moved to R4 register. So R3 value is 04. R4 value is 02. In second time division operation, R3 value is 04. R4 value is 02. Okay. Then subtract operation, that is 02 is subtracted from 04. The answer is 02. It is not 0. So increment R2 content. R2 already 02. After execution of INC R2, the R2 value is 03. Okay. Then again short jump, that is the control is transferred to loop location. Once again the R1 content is moved to accumulator register. So R1 is nothing but accumulator. 09 is moved to accumulator register. Then F0 is nothing but 03. That is R2 is nothing but 03. That value is moved to F0. Okay, then divide A by B, that is 09 divided by 03. The quotient value is 03. Remainder value is 00. Okay, then the quotient value is available in accumulator register. That value is moved to R3 register. Then F0 is nothing but remainder value, that is moved to R4 register. So R3 is nothing but 03. R4 is nothing but 00. Okay, then subtract operation, that is R2 is a subtractor from accumulator. So R2 is nothing but 03. Accumulator value is 03. So 03 is subtracted from 03. The answer is 0. So here the 0 flag is set. So the control is transferred to result location. Okay, that is 8700 address is moved to data pointer. Okay, then R3 value is moved to accumulator register. So what is R3? R3 is nothing but 03. So the quotient value 03 is moved to accumulator register. From accumulator, the answer will be stored in the specified address location, that is 8700. Then R3 is moved to accumulator. Then short jump. So short jump means instead of halt instruction, short jump instruction is used to stop the process. So 8700 indicates result address. So the final answer is 03. So this is the square root of a given number. The next topic is keyboard interface and display unit. So this is the hex keyboard interface. It consists of 16 keys arranged in 4 rows and 4 columns. The keyboard requires 8 lines to make all the connections. When a key is pressed, it short one row and one column. Otherwise, the row and column do not have any connection. The matrix keyboard is interfaced to the microcontroller through programmable I/O port 8255. Rows are connected to the port 1. Columns are connected to port 2. Port 1 is used as output port and port 2 is used as input port. Instead of port 1, port 3 can be used in BSR mode, that is bit set or reset mode. The software technique called matrix is used to read the data from the keyboard. When a key is closed, the corresponding binary code is found by means of the following steps. Step number 1, check for key closure. In this step, all the rows are grounded by outputting zeros to all the rows through output port 1. A key closure is checked by reading the data on the column through input port 2. If all the keys are open, the input reading on data lines will be 1111. If one of the keys is closed, the reading will be less than 1111. This data is inputted to the accumulator and compared with 0F. The condition of 0 flag is a tester to identify the closure of any key. So this is the first step. In second step, identification of key. Once a key closure is found, the key is identified by grounding one row at a time and checking each column for zero. The binary key code is identified through the counter procedure. Initially, the counter is loaded with 0000. For each row, the columns are checked one after another, and for every column, check the counter is incremented. Key closure is identified by a zero in the column, and the content of the counter is the code corresponding to the closed key. Once the key is identified, then the content of the counter is transferred to the accumulator register. In case that is 4x4 matrix keyboard, the low order 4 lines of the ports are used. The high order 4 bits are masked. With all the 8 lines of the ports, 8x8 matrix keyboard can be interfaced by the same procedure. Instead of 16 keys, 64 keys are used in case of 8x8 matrix keyboard. So this is key debound circuit. When a mechanical push button key is pressed or released, the metal contact of the key momentarily bounces before giving a steady straight reading. The bouncing of the key should not be read as an input value. The key bounce can be eliminated from input data by the key debounce technique using either hardware or software. In software technique, the controller waits for about 10 milliseconds to accept a key closure. So this is the 7 segment display interfacing using 8051 microcontroller. 7 segment display are generally used as numerical indicators. It consists of number of LEDs arranged in 7 segments. See A segment, B segment, C segment, D, E, F, G. So totally 7 segments. So it is called as 7 segment LED display. In addition with one more point, that is decimal point. 7 segment displays are available in a single dual in line package. There is one pin for each segment, and these pin are named from A to G. There are two types of 7-segment displays. The first one common anode, second one common cathode. In common anode type, all anodes of LEDs are connected together. See the diagram, all anodes are connected together. In common cathode type, all cathodes are connected together. In common anode, anode segments are connected to plus VCC. In common cathode, all cathode terminals are connected to ground. So, in common anode, on segment value is equal to 0, whereas in common cathode, on segment value is equal to 1. So, this is the interfacing diagram of 7-segment LED display with 8051. In this diagram, a driver circuit IC74LS240 is used for driving the 7-segment display. The interfacing of 7-segment display with the 8051 microcontroller needs a driver circuit, and getting the data from port 3 and display it in port 1. This table shows the hex value of decimal digits 0 to 9 in common anode mode display. So this is 0. If you want to display 0 means, so A segment, B segment, C segment, D segment, E, F. So these segments are on. G segment and decimal point, these two are in off. So here in common anode, so on segment value is equal to 0. Okay, that is A to F is equal to 0 because these segments are on condition. Off condition, that is 0 and decimal point off mode. So here the bit value is equal to 1. Okay, so totally 8 bits A, B, C, D act as LSB. E, F, G and decimal point act as MSB. That is, it is in 8421 code. First, consider MSB value. Okay, so this is bit position 1, bit position 2, bit position 4. This is 8th bit position. So, 8 plus 4 is nothing but 12. 12 equivalent hexadecimal value is C. Similarly, LSB values, all bits are equal to 0. So, LSB answer is 0. Similarly, find out for 1. So, 1 means B and C segment on, the remaining segment off. So, B and C value on, so put 0. The remaining segment value off, so put 1. Okay. So, first find out MSB value. So, here MSB value, that is EFG and decimal point, all bits value 1. So, 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 15. 15 equivalent hexadecimal value is F. Here, LSB, 8th position and 1st position value 1. The remaining 2 position value 0. So, add these 2 values. That is, 8 plus 1 is nothing but 9. So, that is LSB equivalent value. So, this is the way to find out hex value in common anode mode. So, this is common cathode mode. So, common cathode means on segment value 1, off segment value 0. Consider the 0. So, here G and decimal segment off. So, off means 0. Put 0, these 2 segments. The remaining segments value 1. Similarly, find out MSB and LSB value. So, here MSB value, that is position 2 and position 1 value 1. The remaining 2 bits, that is a 4th position and 8th position value 0. So, here 2 plus 1, 3 MSB value. In LSB, all bits values are 1. So 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, 15. 15 equivalent hexadecimal value is F. Similarly, find out digit 9. Okay. If you want, display 9 means here E segment and decimal point value of. Okay, E segment. See here, E segment and decimal point value of. Of segment value 0. The remaining segment value on, that is 1. Okay, then find the MSB and LSB value. Here 4 plus 2 is nothing but 6. Here 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 15. 15 equivalent hexadecimal value is F. So this is cathode mode hex value for decimal digit. So these are the applications of 7 segment displays. Common applications of 7 segment display are in digital clocks, clock radios, calculators, wristwatches, speedometers, motor vehicle odometers, radio frequency indicators. So these are the applications of 7 segment LED display. So this is the program to display digits 0 to 9 using 7 segment LED display with 8051 microcontroller. So 9200 is nothing but data address. Here we are considering 10 datas starting from 0 to 9. So 00, the equivalent hex value is C0. So this is equivalent value of 1. This is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay, already you know how to calculate these values. See here, C0, see here, C0. F9 is nothing but instead of BC, F and E segments on. So put 0 for this and find the equivalent hex value. Okay. So here, the first instruction 80 is moved to accumulator register. Then 4003, this address is loaded into data pointer. Then accumulator content is moved to data pointer. Similarly, FF is moved to accumulator register. Then 4000 address is moved to data pointer. Then accumulator content is moved to the specified address location. Okay, then L call means long call. Here label is data. So the control is transferred to the specified label location. So here 0A is nothing but total number of datas. This data is moved to R2 register. Okay, then 92 is moved to R3 register. Then 00 is moved to R4 register. Then R3 and R4 is nothing but it stores the data address. Okay. So R2 is nothing but high order data address. R4 is nothing but low order data address. Okay. Then R4 content is moved to DPL. So R4 is nothing but 00. So 00 is moved to DPL. Then R3 content is moved to DPH, that is 92 is moved to DPH. Then data pointer is nothing but 9200. The content of 9200 is moved to accumulator register. So the content is C0. So this content is moved to accumulator register. Okay, then 4001, this address is moved to data pointer. Then accumulator content is moved to data pointer, then delay program. Okay, so the first data is moved to accumulator. Through accumulator, that value is outputted to the display unit. So the 7 segment LED display that number using delay program. So this is the delay program. In delay program, two registers are used, one is R0, another one R1. Okay, here FF is moved to R0 register, then FF is moved to R1 register. Here we take any value. Okay, instead of FF, we take any value. So this is our choice. Then once the value is loaded into R0 and R1, then start decrement operation. Okay, after decrementing, check the R1 register whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means the same operation is repeated till the R1 register reaches 0. So after reaching 0, move to the next instruction, that is DJNZR0 loop. So DJNZ means decrement, then check the R0 content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means the same operation is repeated till R0 register reaches 00. Okay, after reaching 0, using return instruction, the control is transferred to this location, that is increment R4. Increment R4 register, that is a low order data address, then decrement R2 register content. Okay, then after that, check the R2 register content whether it reaches 0 or not. If not means the same operation will be repeated till R2 reaches 00. That means first display C0. C0 is nothing but number 0. Okay, first display 0, then 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So after displaying all data, the R2 reaches 00. So once again, the same operation will continue from first instruction. So this is the program of interfacing 7-segment LED display with 8051 microcontroller. The second example, LCD display module. So here I am considering LCD 16x2 display module. So LCD means liquid crystal display. So this is widely used in various electronic applications. It is commonly used in various systems to show different status and parameters. LCD 16x2 has two lines with 16 characters in each line. Each character is made up of 5x8 pixel matrix. So 5x8 is nothing but 5 columns and 8 rows. That is called 5x8 pixel matrix. So this is the pin diagram of LCD 16x2. So here first two pins, that is VSS and VCC of LCD 16x2 are used for ground and supply. Okay, so VCC is nothing but plus 5 volt power supply. Then VSS is nothing but ground signal. Then pin number 3, that is VEE. This pin is used for adjusting the contrast of the display. Voltage on this pin defines contrast on display. Lower the voltage or higher the contrast, we can connect 4.7 kilo ohm for contrast adjustment, or simply connect this pin to ground to get maximum contrast. Then pin number 4, that is RS register select pin. If RS is equal to 0, data on the D0 to D7 pins is considered as a command signal, command register or command signal. Then RS value is equal to 1, data on the D0 to D7 pins is considered as data to display on LCD 16x2. Then pin number 5, that is read write pin. Here RW is equal to 0, it indicates write data to the LCD. Okay, RW is equal to 1 indicates read data from LCD. Then pin number 6, that is E, enable signal. This pin is used to latch the data present on the data pins D0 to D7. High to low pulse with a minimum width of 450 nanosecond is required to latch the data to the display. Then pin number 7 to 14 called data pins, that is D0 to D7. Data pins are used to send data or command to the LCD 16x2 as parallel 8 data bits. Then pin number 15 and 16, that is LED plus and LED minus liquid crystal display do not have their own light like 7-segment LED display. Therefore, the module has a backlight LED. Supply to this LED is provided through these pins only. Then, so these are the command signals commonly used in LCD 16x2. So the first command signal is clear the display screen, then shift the cursor right, then display on, cursor off, then display on, cursor blinking, then force the cursor to the beginning of the first line, then force the cursor to the beginning of the second line, then shift cursor position to the left, then shift cursor position to the right, shift entire display to the left, shift entire display to the right, then two lines 5x8 matrix, 8-bit mode operation, then two lines 5x8 matrix but 4-bit mode operation, then one line 8-bit mode operation, one line 4-bit mode operation. For this command, here hex codes are available. So 0x01 means clear the display screen. For example, 0x14 means shift cursor position to the right. In the program, the hex code is used instead of this command. While printing a character on LCD 16x2, we need to send the ASCII code of the character to LCD 16x2. Suppose we want to print a character H on the LCD, then we should send 0x40H, that is ASCII code of H value, H character, data to the LCD 16x2. The LCD 16x2 has its own controller which does the printing job on the LCD 16x2. Then this is 4-bit mode configuration. This is the format. Only 4 GPIO pins are connected to LCD data, that is D4 to D7 pin, which help to save GPIO pins. By default, LCD 16x2 is in 8-bit mode. To use LCD 16x2 in 4-bit mode, we need to send some command for LCD initialization and configuration. To send these command using this format, D0, D1, these bits are set to 0. D2 is nothing but character font. If the bit value is equal to 0, 5x8 dots. If the bit value is equal to 1, 5x10 dots. Then D3, that is N. N is nothing but number of display lines. If the bit value is equal to 0, 1 line. If the bit value is equal to 1 means that is 2 line. Okay, then D4. D4 is nothing but interface data length. If the bit value is equal to 0 means that is a 4-bit operation. If the bit value is equal to 1 means 8-bit operation. Data length is 8-bit. Okay, then D5 value is equal to 1. So this bit should be set to 1. Then D6 and D7 is nothing but these bits are set to 0. So this is LCD with the custom character. LCD 16x2 can display user-defined custom characters. This can be used for displaying symbols and different patterns like heart symbol, then bell symbol, like that. Okay, that is called custom character. So to print character symbol on LCD, we have to send ASCII code. LCD 16x2 also has feature where we can print out own custom character which is not included in ASCII set of character. Okay, then using CGRAM. CGRAM is nothing but character generator RAM. So LCD 16x2 has memory space of 64 bytes called CGRAM. It is used to make custom patterns. We just have to write the custom pixel value in this memory space. Okay. So here command signal, that is a set CGRAM address, then DB0 to DB5 address, then DB6 is nothing but 1, DB7 value 0, read or write value 0, then register select value also 0. That means this is used to set the address of CG RAM. Okay. Then while providing the address of CG RAM, we have to keep DB6 line always high. This means that address short from 0x40 to store custom character on CG RAM. On LCD 16x2, one character is made up by 5x8 pixel matrix. Consider that we have to design bell shape custom character. We have to define pixel value 0 for pixel off and 1 for pixel on. So we get total 8 values for one custom characters. So custom characters are stored at CG RAM memory location. That is, CG RAM is 64 bytes. Custom character address starts from 0x40 and end at 0x7f. So we can define total 8 custom characters. So this is about LCD 16x2 display module. With this, we come to the end of this video. I hope this video is a useful one. We will meet in the next video shortly. Thank you.